Hi, CBU's Voices of Color Chapter Community. Welcome to part 2B of Men of Color in Advent series. This is the last part of our Men of Color in Advent this year. And this segment is titled Doubting Believers. So we are looking at this from Luke chapter 1, from verse 5 to verse 30. I'm sorry, from verse 5 to verse 25. And this is talking about Zechariah, the high priest at the time of just before Jesus was born. I bring this story in. I never go into Advent without considering the role of John the Baptist and his family because God did that. There was purpose. Advent is all about preparation, and Jesus talks a lot about the issue of preparation for entering the kingdom. So it is important that we are looking at the ways in which God prepared humanity to accept the birth of his son. And right off the bat, we see that Jesus God started in the household of the priest Zechariah with the angel coming to him and telling him that him and his wife, who have been barren, well, they're now in their old age, will have a son. And this son is not the Messiah. However, he will prepare the way. Now, the issue is this man who is a priest did not believe the word of God and challenged the word of God. And he said to him, he said to the angel in verse 18, Zechariah asked the angels, "How can I be sure of this? I am an old man and my wife is well along in years." What I want to bring up about this man of color in this issue is that this man was a spiritual man. This man was a faithful man. However, this man struggled with some issues about the way God works in the world. Okay, that tells us right there that just being a man does not make us completely cognizant of God's activities in the world, nor does it make us completely accepting of God's workings in the world. And not only that, it's okay to question. It's okay to question. And this is the reason why, in this important conversation of gender equality for women of color, it is important for men of color to ask the question, how can we be sure that this message of equality is coming from God? How can we be sure? Because women of color, we stand in a place in history where God is trying to do something new, restoring the world new, because the Bible says in God, in Christ, we're all new creation, and he's trying to bring this whole salvation and redemption thing to pass. And you know what? He's going to talk to some of you men. He's going to come to you and say, "Open the doors for women of color." He's going to say, "Open your pulpits, open your purses, give your backing to these women of color." And some of you are going to be so questions like, for many, many years, we have not done this. We do not have women leadership. We do not have women proclaiming from our pulpits. We do not have women sitting with our pastors. And when women sit separately, we sit separately. And we have this hierarchy. This is how it has been from when I was young to now I'm old. How can we be sure? And I'm going to tell you something, though. When God started to break the news of Jesus's coming, he was willing to back it up. He was willing to back it up with signs and wonders, which he gave to those people that were in doubt. And so here I want to bring out something for to us men of color, that we know as women of color, we know that not all of you stand with us as we stand in this place of preparing the world to receive the message of redemption, of humanity, the bringing back, the reconciliation of men and women of all races together. And as God is picking on all these unlikely candidates to do that work, we know that a lot of our men of color are not with us there. We know that our men of color are doubtful. And we do not condemn you for doubting, but we will ask you, like Zechariah did, to go ask the Lord, how do we know that this is of you? And the Lord will give you all signs. And when you have those signs, it becomes incumbent upon you to open your doors, open your pulpits, open your support, give your support and your backing, because this new kingdom is going to require your participation. God wants to use your pulpit. God wants to use your church. God wants to use your ministry. God wants to use your purses to usher in the kingdom. So while it is okay to doubt, it's not all right to stay in a doubt and do nothing. You must ask a question. Doubt is not a sin, because we have the word of God to respond to us and change us from doubt to faith. But if we choose to stay in doubt, then we have done what is wrong, because we do not allow space. And I believe that the same God who did not condemn Zechariah, but who gave him a sign that he would know that this kingdom being ushered in is of God, that God truly is asking him and his family to be at the forefront of something new, of something impossible, of something beautiful, of something redemptive, that he will make it clear that it is God asking him. So ponder that, go back and read that doubting people, folks, priests and whatever in Luke 1, and come back for the next segment. Thank you. God bless you.